Nobody likes slow pages, and it's especially relevant to websites built with WordPress CMS. However, features like Redis help increase WordPress performance. And if you just want to see the configuration process of Redis for WordPress, feel free to use timestamps for this video or just move the timeline. But at the beginning, for a better understanding of WordPress optimization, I want to share the basics and reveal crucial factors that affect your website performance in the first place. So factor number one, called TTFB, stands for Time to First Byte. It measures the response time of a web server to the initial user's request. The faster server responds to the request, the quicker your website is going to load. I also have to mention that the distance between user and the web server plays a huge role. The longer the distance between the end user and the web server, the longer it will take for the traffic to travel. So make sure that you place your website in the right location for your visitors. WordPress itself, as well as other websites, have no control over this parameter. TTFB is defined exclusively by the web server. Different web servers offer different response time, and the fastest one today is Lightspeed, and this is exactly what we have under the hood for WebHostMost, so make sure to choose the proper web server to get the fastest TTFB. The second factor is called the DOM size, which stands for Document Object Model. Websites consist of HTML files, and each tag inside of HTML file is called node, including all the JavaScripts, PHP requests, and third-party resources that website has to trigger each time you request a specific page. With that said, it would be best to keep the DOM size as small as possible. On WordPress, you would have to use less plugins, so that way you can save the DOM size and get faster access. Also, try avoiding theme builders because they adds up to the DOM size by default a lot. And next thing is Redis. Redis is an open source in-memory storage that is designed to store crucial website objects inside of the random access memory instead of the disk space, because that way computer can get access to those files faster. Now, finally, let's configure Redis for WordPress. First thing, we have to get into our user account and then log into web control panel. Direct admin in my case, then locate website management, Redis, and activate this toggle. What I just did now is I activated Redis for the system itself, but it's not connected to my website. For instance, I already have an empty website, it's just default WordPress installation with some plugin that will let me connect my Redis to WordPress website. And keep in mind that not all the cache plugins work with all the servers. You would better do some research and make sure that plugin that you're about to use is actually compatible with the web server. Under the hood of WebHostMost, we have Lightspeed web server, and luckily Lightspeed introduced a free plugin for WordPress that's called Lightspeed Cache. And all we have to do is navigate to our WordPress admin panel, Lightspeed Cache plugin, Cache tab, Object, and then you'll see Object Cache. We have to enable it, then method, we have to select Redis, and for the host field, we have to insert that link that system has generated for us. And then the last thing is also important is port. Here you have to understand one little thing. It is giving you a few options to select the port, but options with actual port numbers can be used when you use web sockets. In our case, we use system sockets or Unix socket, which requires port 0. Once everything is set, we have to just save changes and make sure that the connection test passed. Once it passed, you can be sure that Object Cache or Redis is enabled for your WordPress website. And you can check the page now, it works much faster because Redis is enabled and it's doing exactly what I just told you. So that way we get much better performance. If this information was helpful, make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, join our community, all the links down in the description below, leave all your questions in the comment section, and stay tuned for more videos. And let's build more amazing projects with WebHostMost.